It's a simple idea, which will be a key focus of Let's Move over the next year, but it is an idea that can help families create healthier new habits. And the idea is to help families start cooking again. Now, I know this might not seem like an earth-shattering notion, though neither was planting a garden in the White House, I will remind you. But research clearly shows that home cooking is one of the single most impactful ways for families to improve their health. One study shows that home cooking is actually a better predictor of how well families eat than their income. And that's not surprising, because food prepared at home is lower in saturated fat, sodium, cholesterol, and calories than food prepared away from home. Because when you cook at home, you're in control of your nutrition. You decide the ingredients to use. You decide the portion sizes. You decide whether there's a vegetable on the plate or not. But unfortunately for many families, home cooking has fallen by the wayside. And many folks feel like they just don't have the time to cook, or they don't know how. Some think it's more expensive to prepare balanced home cooked meals, so they don't do it. But it hasn't always been that way. See, back in the day, for you young people, the day is like when I was young. Folks used to cook all the time. That was certainly true in my family growing up. My mother had a strict food budget, and every Saturday she wrote out her list for the week, headed to the grocery store down the street, and she had every meal planned out for the week. That roast beef for Sunday dinner would be sandwiches for Monday and Tuesday lunches. Wednesday night was liver night. It was a very sad night in our Thursday might be spaghetti, Friday fish, and once in a great while, we'd order a pizza or pick up a burger at the drive-thru, but we usually couldn't afford to eat out, so those were exceptions. My grandmother had done the same thing for her family, and she worked full-time for most of her life. See, back then, unless you were rich, cooking was a matter of survival. It was a way of life. But like a lot of folks in my generation, I found that by the time I grew up and went off to school and started my career, things had changed. I remember one Saturday afternoon as a young boy, you're working crazy hours, I was talking to my grandmother over the phone, and the first thing she asked me, she said, "What are you cooking?" And I was like, "Grandma, really? I am a lawyer, I do not cook." You see, my parents urged me to focus on my studies and career above all else. They had worked hard to support my dreams, so they didn't want me to worry about traditional things like cooking. They felt like I could always learn to cook later. And that was all well and good for a while, until I had a family of my own. And I was fine when my kids were little, because we went from breastfeeding straight to what Barack and I called the jar stage, when an entire meal for a baby came in a single jar. Barack and I, we loved the jar stage. We were masters of the jar stage. Providing a balanced meal was so easy. Chicken and rice in a jar. Peas and spinach, jar. Peaches, bananas, jar, big jar. No need to cook, boil, bake, it was all there for us in those marvelous little baby food jars. It was heaven. But then our babies outgrew the jar stage, and suddenly we were faced with the reality that we might actually have to use the appliances in our kitchen to feed our children. And we slowly figured it out. We started with the basics like broiled chicken and rice and steamed broccoli, scrambled eggs. That's really all Barack would do, the eggs. And we did our best to cook regularly at home, but like so many working parents, we both had demanding jobs, we were always exhausted, and over time we started giving in and popping things into the microwave. We're spending way too much of our monthly budget ordering takeout, which in turn resulted in less than optimal health outcomes for our kids. So as my story hopefully illustrates, while we often frame this cooking problem as a time problem or a budget problem, For many folks, it's actually a skills problem. Because when you don't have those basic cooking and budgeting skills that my mother and grandmother had, everything takes longer and costs much more. You don't know how to plan a full week of meals, so you go back and forth to the grocery store. You don't know how to cut a whole chicken yourself, so you pay more for the pre-cut parts. You've never learned the basics of cooking, so even simple dishes take longer to prepare than they should. And today, a lot of folks think it's quicker and cheaper to just grab some fast food. But the fact is that with the right recipes and a few basic skills, there are countless recipes that families can prepare in less than 30 minutes, meals that actually cost less than going through the drive-thru. For example,